Suddenly you will feel that some area of your life which you were confused from very, very, very long, or rather I would say from end of June last year. You are fighting a battle, but when you were fighting, you forgot why you were fighting at the first place. And at the end, you realize that you won the battle, but you lost the war. They say operation was successful, but the patient was dead. So this video is regarding the transit of Mars, which has happened in Taurus, and it's going to be there for the next 40-45 days. Okay, so we are going to discuss in short what this transit will bring for us, and to the extent these symptoms will be visible is going to depend on the dasha which you are running and your individual horoscope and placement of planets originally in the sign of Taurus and the placement of Mars in your birth chart. Alright, so there you go. If you are new, then please like, comment, share and subscribe. And if you want a consultation from me regarding this transit, if you want to know how this will turn out for you, particularly for your horoscope, then you could go to my website to book a reading. You will find the link in the description section down below. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him. So now what has happened is Mars entered the sign of exaltation June last year. Yes, last year. We all know where Mars gets exalted, right? It's in the sign of Capricorn. But the problem was, it was not alone. As Mars was moving ahead in the sign of Capricorn, two things happened. It went stationary, then it went retrograde, and then it was conjunct Ketu, because Mars and Ketu were in the sign of Capricorn for last 6 months during that time, you know, from June till the end of 2018 almost. So when a planet gets exalted in transit, what happens? Like for example, Mars in this case. So just check whichever houses Mars rules in your chart. So you would have felt that when Mars entered Capricorn, you very strongly needed to execute the rulerships of Mars. So for example, suppose Mars is your 10th lord, then you would have felt that now you strongly need to activate your career house, your name, fame, status. What do people think of you in general, in the society? What is your name? Or if it's the Lagna lord, then the body. That means whenever a planet gets exalted in transit, we feel very positive about making the necessary changes which can give us fulfillment in the longer run. During that transit, for those days or those months or those years. But now what happened was, Mars stationed and it went retrograde. So that period was around June, around that time. So what happened was Mars realized that it is not going to be the way I think it should be, or it need not be the way I want it to be. Maybe there is some other alternative. And because of that, the planet went retrograde for 2 months. Because the planet was very confident that I thought I did what I was supposed to do, or what I should have done. But maybe that was not enough, because they say that your best need not be the best. So when Mars entered Capricorn, that time we felt that yes, we can make the change now. But then it went retrograde, and then when it went direct and it started going ahead, then again Ketu was there. So Ketu gives you this feeling of headless victory. It's like a victory which is not worth celebrating. It's like the situation of Great Britain after the World War II. Miserable, pathetic. That's just one way to understand this. So it's like saying you won everybody. Or rather than saying you won, you defeated everybody, but you did not win anybody's heart. So then finally Mars left Ketu around September, and then it went into Aquarius and then Pisces. And then recently there was this very miserable conjunction of Mars and Uranus, and that conjunction had taken the world for a ride. In the last 45 days, you would have seen so many dangerous activities have happened. In India, there was this attack on Pulwama, then there was attack on Pakistan, then Pakistan retaliated. Then in New Zealand, this thing happened, and so many other events which I can go on and on quoting. That's not important. The point here is, Mars again entered the Mool Trikon sign, which is his own sign, Aries, recently for last 50 days. So whenever a planet enters Mool Trikon, it also feels very positive to make those necessary decisions which according to that planet will give himself fulfillment in the long run, to fulfill the agenda of its lordships. And now what has happened is, Mars has left the Mool Trikon sign Aries and it has entered Taurus. And Taurus, always remember, is the opposite sign of Scorpio, because Scorpio is the sign of fear, terror, and Taurus is the sign of stability. Now that's a very tricky situation here. Although Taurus is a great sign for any planet to be in, apart from Jupiter, of course. I mean, it's not bad for Jupiter, but for material, for spiritual reasons, it may not be great. But now for Mars also, it's a very precarious situation. In a way, it's like saying it's good to be grounded. But at the same time, Mars also needs to act instinctively. That could be missing during this transit. But the point here is, Mars is not alone here. Mars is being aspected by one of his great friends and a great natural benefic, Jupiter, from the sign of Scorpio. Of course, Jupiter is going to enter Sagittarius, and from 29 to end of April almost, it will stay in Sagittarius. So Mars will be to some extent bereft of the beneficial aspect of Jupiter, because Mars will be in the beginning degrees and Jupiter will be in the end degrees of Scorpio and beginning of Sagittarius. So unfortunately, it's going to be a bit deprived of the benefic aspect of Jupiter. But at least till the end of this month, March, and from the end of April to around first week of May, Mars will receive the aspect of Jupiter for these 2 weeks at least. 1 week here, 1 week there. So now what happens is, depending on the houses which Mars rules in your chart, you will feel that now, rather than behaving like Aries, what is Aries? Aries acts first and then he thinks, oh my god, what did I do? Was it right? Was it wrong? So now in Taurus, what happens? You think first and then you act. That's a very good thing about Taurus. And there's something very interesting here. Mars, what is he doing from Taurus? From Taurus, he's throwing the eighth aspect to Ketu. Do not forget this. Rahu Ketu gives results of the planets which aspect them. Should I repeat? Rahu Ketu also gives results of those planets which aspect them and which planets they are conjunct. Which means, if suppose Mars is aspecting Rahu or Ketu, then Ketu also gives the results of Mars. Now Ketu is already aspected conjunct Saturn. So it is also going to give the results of Saturn. And after 29th, when Jupiter is going to be conjunct with Ketu, then Rahu and Ketu are also going to give results of Jupiter. Why Rahu? Because Jupiter from there, from Sagittarius, will aspect Rahu. Saturn is already aspecting. So Rahu Ketu will give results of Jupiter and Saturn the entire month of April. And Ketu will specifically also give results of Mars. So April is going to be a very dynamic time. So the houses which are ruled by Jupiter, Saturn and Mars, they will go for an inevitable change. You will see this change manifesting during the month of April. Okay, so that is what I will say, that now there is some peace which is coming up. Now this does not mean that there will be no bad events. Of course, that will depend on the dasha and what individually people are facing in this world. But at least Mars is out of the conjunction of Uranus. So that's a good news. And yeah, that is what I wanted to say. And yes, some of you have been asking me when I will make videos on this Jupiter-Saturn-Ketu conjunction. You will hopefully get the video on 29th itself, okay? So there you go. If you are new, then please like, comment, share and subscribe. Hit the thumbs up. And if you want a consultation from me, then please go down to my website, okay? God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him.